Hi everyone! Welcome back to Mom and Me Beauty. Today, by special request, I am comparing the Sweet Peach by Too Faced palette with the dupe that I had mentioned in our favorites video last week. And if you'd like to check that video out, I will link it up here in the cards for you and down below in the description box. But the dupe that I found for it was on a website called shophush.com. And that is the Sugar Palette by Face Candy. So I found something that was very comparable to this. I mean, the colors in here are almost identical in every single case in terms of finish and shade and color. And this palette is a fraction of the cost of this palette. If you're joining us again, welcome back. If you're new here, consider subscribing. We do post two beauty videos a week. On Mondays is Mom and Me Day, and on Thursdays is either Teen Take with my daughter Emma or Mom Moment with me. We do have a focus on drugstore brands and less expensive options for all of your beauty needs. And without further ado, let's get started. So I swatched out every single color in the Too Faced palette and then put it up against what I thought was either the identical shade or the close enough shade to it out of the Face Candy palette. And surprisingly, shadow for shadow, the finish and the color was almost identical, if not identical. And I will be showing you arm swatches with colors right next to each other so you can tell for yourself if it really is the dupe. In terms of packaging, both palettes have a hard tin exterior. They both have a decent sized mirror. So that's the Sweet Peach. And this one is the Face Candy. So both have quite a nice sized mirror. And I did have to use that in the tutorial, which is going to be coming at the end of this video. If you would like to see just that tutorial, I'll put the timestamp right here so you can fast forward to that section. The shadows in here do not appear in the same place in terms of where they appear in the Too Faced palette. The Sweet Peach palette definitely has that peach smell that's very, Too Faced. That is what they do. You definitely can smell the peach in the palette. The Sugar palette does not have a scent to it at all. So if scents bother you, this might be another bonus for this palette. Not only the cost, but the fact that it doesn't have any scent to it at all. So let's get into some arm swatches. What I did was I went in the Sweet Peach palette from left to right, top to bottom. So I started on the top row, I worked my way across, and I took the corresponding color from the Face Candy palette, the Sugar palette, that I thought was, you know, as close as I could or the exact dupe. So this first picture you see is just the top row, and I've labeled which ones are Too Faced and which ones are the Face Candy shadows. And like you can see here, it's so close, if not exact on dupe, that you really can't tell the difference unless you know yourself. Second row, same thing. I apologize that the first couple of colors in every row you can't really see on my arm because they are so close to my natural skin color, but the finish of them, like I said, is exact same, if not very close. And then finally the bottom row. Now, I did find in the Face Candy palette that some of the shadows were a little bit powdery. Those tended to be the matte shades, the matte lighter colors. So like glaze, latte, whipped cream, creme brulee, those tend to be a little bit more powdery. And then also licorice, which is the matte black. But you kind of find that across a lot of palettes, regardless of whether they're high end or drugstore. So other than that, the pigmentation on the Sugar palette is just as good, if not better, than the Too Faced palette, I find, in my opinion. And the cost is what really did it for me. It's what really made this all worthwhile. So the Sweet Peach palette by Too Faced is going to run you $49. And the Sugar palette from shophush.com is going to run you $10. Yes, $10. They do have dupes for a lot of other palettes. They have one on there for the Huda Beauty, their new eyeshadow palette. That keeps selling out though. So every time I go to buy it or purchase it, they've sold out. And then I have to wait till they restock. So hopefully I'll get my hands on that soon as well. And they also have a dupe for a couple of the Naked palettes. They have a dupe for the Anastasia Beverly Hills, both their Modern Renaissance palette, and they also have one for the new Subculture palette. That one also continues to run out. So if you'd like to try those, go to shophush.com, get notified when they're in stock, and get your hands on them. Everything that I purchased from shophush.com is excellent quality. I have no complaints whatsoever. And I go there first usually to shop, and then I go to Ulta or Sephora. So check that website out. Now we're gonna go on to the tutorial, but don't forget, stop the video down below, put your guess. Which side is which? Is this the Too Faced side or the Face Candy side? And is this the Too Faced or the Sweet Candy side? Stop the video, let me know down below in the comment section. I would love to know. On with the tutorial. Okay, so I hope you've made your guess already. If you haven't, here's what it is. On the right-hand side is the Sugar palette by Face Candy. And on the left is the Too Faced Sweet Peach. Did you get it right? Okay, so let me pause here for a few seconds. Just to let you know, I've primed my eyes with the same primer, Wet n Wild Photo Focus Eye Primer, and wherever I could, I used separate brushes for each palette. If I had to use the same brush for both, I thoroughly cleansed it before using it in the other palette. Also, because the positions of the shadows are not the same in each palette and the shade names are different between palettes, I'll describe the shade I'm using for each step. Okay, let's get on with it. The first shade I used was a cream-colored matte from both palettes, and I used that to set the primer and neutralize my natural skin tone. The second shade is going in my crease to add depth and dimension. This shade is also matte and like a burnt orange to reddish brown in both palettes. The next shade is one of my favorite in both palettes. It is coral but pulls more pink and is a shimmer finish with a little glitter as well. I applied this wet to the lid using the same setting spray on both shadows and on both lids. For my outer V, I used another favorite shade from both palettes. It is a deep plum with pink, coral, and silver speckles of glitter. Oh my god, how I love this shade. After applying it, I blended it into the coral shade on the lid and into the crease to make the transition between the colors seamless. I then used the same shade from both palettes and applied it to my lower lash line to make my eyes appear slightly larger. Then, moving on to the brow highlight, I used the same cream matte shadow that I used as the base color in the first step. And finally, I chose the shimmer shade that is a cross between pale peach and like champagne from each palette as my inner corner highlight. I applied this wet as well. And that is the completed look. Can you tell the difference between the two? Let me know down in the comment section below. And that is it for this video. I hope that you really enjoyed. I hope that I was able to give you an affordable option for a palette that either you've been eyeing like I did, or something great to add to your collection, something new and fun to add to your collection. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up if you will. That way I know that you enjoyed this dupe video and I can continue to make more videos like this where I find dupes for you of higher end products versus more affordable products. And again, don't forget, if you're new here, please subscribe to our channel. Hit that subscribe button down below and the little bell that is right next to it so you're notified every time we upload a new video. Don't forget to share us with your friends and family, because once we get to 100 subscribers, and as of the day that we are filming this, we are up to 97 subscribers, so we are three away. But once we hit 100 subscribers, we will be having our first ever giveaway on this channel. And Emma and I are so excited, we cannot wait. So help us get there. Make sure you hit that subscribe button down below. Don't forget to connect with us on Instagram under MomNMeBeauty and with Emma under Emma_N_2004. Thank you again so very much for watching. We really, really do appreciate it. And we can't wait to see you in our next Mom and Me video. Bye, everyone.